हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल कैटलिस्ट केमिस्ट्री क्लास। इन टुडेज क्लास आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस द चैप्टर केमिकल बॉन्डिंग सिनॉप्सिस एंड सम शॉर्टकट्स एंड ट्रिक्स फॉर द कॉम्पिटेटिव एग्जाम्स। सो बिफोर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट, इफ यू आर नॉट सब्सक्राइब टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल प्लीज डू सब्सक्राइब एंड शेयर इट विद योर फ्रेंड्स। सो what is the cause of chemical combination? So there are two causes. One is tendency to acquire minimum energy and tendency to acquire noble gas configuration, which means to attain octet electronic configuration or stable electronic configuration. Then classification of bonds. So chemical bonds is mainly classified into two types based on their dissociation enthalpy, that is bond dissociation enthalpy. One is strong bond, another one is weak bond. Again, strong bond is further classified into four types: ionic bond, covalent bond, coordinate bond, metallic bond. Then weak bond is further classified into hydrogen bond and van der Waals bond. So here, based on the particles involved in chemical combination, we can predict the type of bonding. If one metal and one non-metals are involved in bonding, the type of chemical bonding is ionic bonding. If both are non-metals, then it is covalent bonding. If both are metal, then it is metallic bonding. Then if one of the particle is electron deficient molecule, that acts as Lewis acid, and another one is electron rich molecule that acts as Lewis base, then the type of bond is coordinate bond, or which is also known as dative bond. Then one more type of bond is there, that is a weak bond. So in weak bond we have two types. One is van der Waals interaction or van der Waals force, another one is hydrogen bond. So we can expect hydrogen bond only when the hydrogen is directly attached to any of these more electronegative elements like fluorine, nitrogen, oxygen, and in rare cases with chlorine also. So I will explain hydrogen bonding here only, because it's a very simple topic. So hydrogen bonding is further classified into two types: intermolecular hydrogen bonding and intramolecular hydrogen bonding. So what is meant by intermolecular and intramolecular hydrogen bonding? So as the name itself indicates, intermolecular hydrogen bonding means the hydrogen bonding is present in between any two molecule. So if you consider an example of H2O, so here we have oxygen, the central atom, which is attached to two hydrogen atom, and it has two lone pair electron. Similarly, we consider one more water molecule. Similarly, one more water molecule. So here, in every water molecule, hydrogen is directly attached to more electronegative element, oxygen. Then this hydrogen of one water molecule makes hydrogen bond with oxygen of the adjacent water molecule, and hydrogen bonding is represented by dotted structure. So if this hydrogen bonding is present in between the two different molecule, which is known as intermolecular hydrogen bonding. If you consider intramolecular hydrogen bonding, then hydrogen bonding is present within the molecule. So consider ortho nitro phenol. So we know that phenol means, which consists of OH group, and at ortho position we have nitro group. So here, this hydrogen is directly attached to oxygen atom, and the same hydrogen makes a hydrogen bonding with the oxygen that is attached to a nitrogen group. So that this type of hydrogen bonding is known as intramolecular, that takes place within the molecule. And the first type is intermolecular. The hydrogen bonding takes place between any two molecule. And you know that the second type of weak bond, that is van der Waals forces. What is van der Waals forces then? It is also one of the weakest type of chemical bond or chemical interaction that consists of three types. One is dipole-dipole interaction. Dipole-induced dipole interaction. And the third one is induced dipole interaction, which is also known as London force or dispersion force. So it is also, I will explain here only. Dipole-dipole interaction is, we can expect this type of van der Waals interaction in polar molecule. The van der Waals force between any two polar molecule, we can expect dipole-dipole interaction. And between one polar and non-polar molecule, we can expect dipole-induced dipole interaction. And between two non-polar molecule, we can expect induced dipole interaction, which is also known as London force or dispersion force. Now we can discuss one by one, that is strong bonds, four types of strong bonds. The first one is electrovalent or ionic bond. It's a chemical bond formed between two or more atoms as a result of complete transfer of one or more valence electrons from one atom to another atom. Then, how can we represent the formula of a compound? So here, I have taken the example of calcium chloride. So first, we have to write the cation along with its charge. Similarly, we have to write the anion along with its charge. So this is the first step. And in second step, we have to cross multiply the magnitude of the charge with respect to the opposite ions, like calcium. So chloride consists of -1 charge. The magnitude is cross multiplied to calcium. Similarly, for chlorine, the magnitude of the charge of calcium, which is cross multiplied to chlorine, is Ca1Cl2. Which is simply called as CaCl2. Similarly, if we consider the second example, aluminium sulfate. So Al3+, aluminium carries 3+ charge, and SO4, which carries 2- charge. In the second step, we have to cross multiply the magnitude of the charge with oppositely charged ions, so that Al2, SO4 carries 3. So this is how we can write the formula of the ionic compound. And here we can observe the formation of ionic compound of NaCl. So before transferring one electron from sodium to chlorine, sodium has an atomic state here, which has, and sodium, after donating one electron to chlorine, sodium becomes Na+ ion and chlorine becomes Cl- ion. Then, determination of lattice enthalpy, which is explained by Born-Haber cycle by taking an example of sodium chloride. So, we know that sodium is present in solid state and chlorine is present in gaseous state. So, we can write the formation of NaCl like Na+ ½ Cl2 gives rise to NaCl. and the change in energy, which is known as enthalpy of formation. That is formation of one mole of compound with by the addition of a respective constituent particles. But this is not happens in a single step like this. First, sodium that is present in solid state is converted to gaseous state directly. What is the process that converts solid state to gaseous state? It is sublimation. So that change in enthalpy is known as enthalpy of sublimation. Then that sodium gas in which electron is lost by sodium atom to become Na plus. Then what is the amount of energy liberated when amount of energy required to remove the electron from an outermost gaseous atom, outermost shell of an isolated gaseous atom, that is ionization enthalpy. Then if you come to the chlorine, we know that chlorine exists as a gaseous state with the diatomic state. So the diatomic state of chlorine get converted to chlorine in atomic state, and the change in enthalpy is known as enthalpy of dissociation or enthalpy of atomization. Then chlorine can accept the electron that is donated by sodium, and it becomes Cl minus. And the ability to accept an electron is known as electron affinity. Now we have sodium ion and chloride ion. Those sodium and chloride ions is going to form one mole of ionic compound, and the change in enthalpy is known as lattice energy. Then what's the definition for lattice energy? It's the energy change occurs when one mole of ionic compound is formed from its constituent ions. Then we have some relationship here. For an ionic compound to be soluble in water, the hydration enthalpy must be greater than lattice enthalpy. Lattice enthalpy, which is inversely proportional to solubility, while hydration enthalpy is directly proportional to solubility. And hydration enthalpy, which is directly proportional to the ratio of 1 by R plus plus 1 by R minus, while those R plus and R minus are the radius of cation as well as anion. Then polarization, which is explained by Fajan's rule. What is meant by Fajan's rule? So students, you know that if you consider any ionic compound which is not 100% ionic, which consists of some percentage of covalent character. Similarly, if you consider any covalent molecule which is not 100% covalent, which consists of some ionic compound percentage or percentage of ionic bond. So here, Fajan's rule explains the covalent nature in ionic bond. So before going to explain the Fajan's rule, you have to know the definition for polarization power and polarizability. What is meant by polarization power? It's the ability of cation to polarize a nearby anion is called polarization power of cation. Then polarizability, which is an ability of anion to get polarized by the cation. Polarization of anion causes some sharing of electron between the ions, so ionic bond acquires certain covalent character. So polarization is directly proportional to covalent character. Then the magnitude of polarization depends upon a number of factors suggested by Fajan. And the factors are known as Fajan's rule. So simplified form of Fajan's rule is here. Smaller the size of cation, larger the size of anion, greater the charge on cation and anion, greater is the covalent character. Here we have some examples that explains these three factors. So we have considered alkali metal chlorides. And as we know that down the group in alkali metals, the size of cation increases. So the Fajans rule is, smaller the size of cation, covalent character increases. But if you consider this decreasing order of covalent character, we can observe here, because down the group cationic radius increases, so that covalent character decreases due to increase in size of cation. If the covalent character decreases, means ionic character, obviously, which is just opposite, which increases it. Then the second example we have considered, the sodium halides, in which we have considered the size of anion with respect to 17th group, that is halogens. Here also, similarly, as we move down the group, the size of anion increases from fluorine to iodine. So that as larger the size of anion, increases the covalent character based on Fajans rule. So that NaF, which is greater than NaCl, greater than NaBr, greater than NaI. This gives the decreasing ionic character because of increase in anionic size. If ionic character decreases, means covalent character increases. And the third example, which is based on charge on cation and anion. So, which gives increasing covalent character due to increase in charge on anion and increase in size of anion. We know that anion is having larger size than that of its parental atom, and cation is smaller size than that of its parental atom. So here we have same cation, that is sodium, which is bonded to different anions like nitrogen, oxygen, and fluorine. So fluorine consists of minus one charge, oxygen consists of minus two charge, while nitrogen consists of minus three charge. As the charge on cation or anion increases, then covalent character also increases. Then Fajans rule, the factors affecting polarization. The first factor is size of cation. So polarization of the anion increases as the size of cation decreases. That is polarization inversely proportional to size of cation. So if you consider second group chlorides, alkaline earth metal chlorides. As we move down the group, we know that size of cation increases. If size of cation increases, covalent character decreases, ionic character increases. So here we can observe in this list, barium chloride, which is more ionic, while beryllium chloride, which is more covalent. Then greatest polarizing power of beryllium 2 plus ion shows its maximum covalent nature in a period. Then if you consider across the period, the size of cation decreases and charge on cation increases. So if the charge on cation increases or size of cation decreases, obviously covalent character increases and metallic character decreases, that is ionic character decreases. Then size of anion. If the size of anion increases for a given cation, the covalent character also increases. That means nature of polarization, which is directly proportional to size of anion. Consider calcium halides, in which cation will be same and anion will be down the group in 17th group, that is halogens. As we know that down the group, anionic size increases. As the size of anion increases, covalent character increases, while ionic character decreases. CaI2, which is more covalent, while CaF2, which is more ionic in nature. Then charge on cation and anion. So polarization, which is directly proportional to charge on cation and anion. So as the charge on cation is directly proportional to polarization, which is nothing but covalent character. As we have considered NaCl, MgCl2, AlCl3, SiCl4. As we move across the period, the charge on cation increases, which means the size of cation goes on decreases. So as the charge anion increases, covalent character increases, obviously ionic character decreases, which in turn decreases the melting point of the crystal. Then charge on anion directly proportional to polarization, directly proportional to covalent nature, then inversely proportional to melting point of the compound. Electronic configuration of cation. So polarization capacity of cation having pseudo inert gas configuration is high. If the size of cation is same than that of carbon having inert gas configuration. So here CuCl and NaCl, we have taken an example. Both CuCl and NaCl, in which Cu and Na carries the same charge, that is Cu plus and Na plus. But if you consider Cu plus and Na plus, both the cation, that is one is a pseudo inert gas configuration, another one is actual inert gas configuration, have same charge and size. But the polarizing power of Cu plus is more than Na plus because of its electronic configuration. If you consider Na plus, which is having the NS2 and NP6 configuration, it is an actual inert gas configuration. But if you consider Cu plus, which consists of NS2, NP6 and ND10, which is a pseudo inert gas configuration. Hence, sodium acts as ionic compound while Cu plus acts as covalent compound. So CuCl has more covalent character than NaCl. Here we can observe the formation of NaCl. Sodium donates one electron to chlorine. So chlorine accepts one electron from sodium. Sodium, after donating one electron, becomes Na plus. Chlorine, after accepting an electron, becomes Cl minus ion. Covalent bond. Whenever chemical bond is formed by sharing of electrons, mutual sharing of electrons, then it is named as covalent bond. Lewis octet rule. The octet rule states that atom gain or loss electrons to attain an outer shell electron configuration nearest that of a noble gas. The attractive force between atom is informally measured with this rule. Then, what are the exceptions for octet rule? The first one is incomplete octet molecule or electron deficient molecule. If you consider second group compounds and third group compounds, not all the compounds, most of the compounds in second group and third group, like BeCl2, BF3, AlCl3, BCl3. So if you consider these type of molecule, can I take an example of BCl3? So which consists of only three bonds, which is equivalent to 6 electrons. Still, to become octet or to become stable, it requires 2 more electrons. So that which acts as electron deficient, and hence it is considered as incomplete octet molecule. Then expansion of octet or electron efficient molecules, which means electron rich molecules. If you consider the examples like PCl5, SF6, IF7, so these molecule, in which I will consider PCl5 for an example. So PCl5, that consists of 5 bonds equivalent to 10 electrons. So if the molecule is said to be stable, which consists of just 8 electrons, but PCl5 molecule consists of 10 electrons. Similarly, SF6 molecule consists of 12 electrons. IF7 consists of 14 electrons. So these type of molecule consists of more than 8 electrons. Hence, they are considered as expansion of octet. Then pseudo inert gas configuration. Just now we have discussed a pseudo inert gas configuration in the topic polarization. So cations of transition metals which contains 18 electrons in their outermost orbit. That 18 electron, which is a pseudo inert gas configuration. What are the examples? Ga3 plus, Cu plus, Ag plus, Zn2 plus, Cd2 plus, Sn4 plus, Pb4 plus. These ions consist of 18 electrons in their outermost orbit. And those 18 electrons are the pseudo inert gas configuration. Then odd electron molecules. Central atom has an unpaired electron or odd number of electron. So for example, NO, NO2, ClO2, in which the central atoms nitrogen as well as chlorine that consists of unpaired electron or odd number of electron, which do not give 8 electrons in their outermost shell. So here we have some examples how to write a Lewis dot structure of an element. So those dots that is represented or surrounded the element that represents the number of valence electrons. Then coordinate bond, which is also known as dative bond. The bond formed between two atoms in which a contribution of an electron pair is made by one of them while the sharing is done by both the atoms. It is represented by single-headed arrow and considered as sigma bond. Atom, ion, molecule donating an electron pair is called as donor or Lewis base. And the particle accepting electron pair is called acceptor or Lewis acid. So we can give an example of formation of NH4+. We know that NH3 has three NH bonds and one lone pair electron on nitrogen. In NH4+ formation, this lone pair is donated to H+ ion, donated by nitrogen. So here we can observe the diagram of NH4+ ion. So before formation of NH4+, we have NH3 group. And nitrogen consists of one lone pair electron. That lone pair is donated to hydrogen, that is in H+ state. So here we have mentioned the coordinate bond, like single headed arrow. And you can observe the formation of ozone molecule here. So in ozone molecule also, one of the oxygen donates its lone pair electron to the third oxygen atom, and which forms dative bond with third oxygen. Formal charge. What is the formal charge? The formal charge of an atom in a polyatomic molecule or iron may be defined as the difference between the number of valence electrons of that atom in an isolated or free state and the number of electrons assigned to the same atom in the Lewis structure, which is given by a simplified formula Fc, which is equal to V minus N minus B by 2. Fc is formal charge, V is number of valence electrons, N is number of non-bonding valence electrons, that is lone pair electrons. Then B, total number of electrons shared in bonds, that is bonded pair electron. So formal charge, which is equal to number of valence electrons in the neutral atom minus number of valence electrons around the atom in the molecule, which means number of valence electrons in the neutral atom minus half into number of electrons in covalent bonds minus number of electrons in lone pair. Modern theories of covalent bond. Valence bond theory, valence shell electron pair repulsion theory, molecular orbital theory. First, we will consider valence bond theory. And I know that you are familiar with the postulates, but still, I have to explain some of the postulates. Like, according to this theory, a covalent bond is formed by the overlapping of atomic orbitals. Important points of this theory are summarized as follows. Orbitals undergoing overlapping should be half-filled. Half-filled orbitals should contain the electron with opposite spin. Strength of a covalent bond depends upon the extent of overlapping. For example, axial or lateral overlapping takes place. If the atomic orbitals overlap axially, then the bond formed is called sigma bond. Then, if the atomic orbital overlaps sideways or lateral overlapping, the bond formed is pi bond. A sigma bond is always stronger than a pi bond. Covalent bonds formed by the overlapping of SS, SP orbitals are always sigma. By the overlapping of PP orbitals, one sigma and two pi bonds are possible. Increasing strength of sigma covalent bonds is in the order SS overlapping, which is lesser than SP lesser than PP overlapping, when internuclear distance is constant, that is same. A single covalent bond is always a sigma bond. In a double covalent bond, one is sigma and the second formed bonds are pi bond, or later formed bonds are pi bond. Similarly, in triple covalent bond also, first formed bond is sigma, later formed bonds are pi bond. Bond parameters. First one is bond length, which is also known as bond distance. Bond length, the average distance between the nucleus of two atoms is known as bond length. Normally, it is represented as Armstrong unit. Factors affecting the bond length, that is electronegativity, change in electronegativity. Bond length, which is inversely proportional to change in electronegativity value. And bond energy, which is directly proportional to electronegativity. Hence, we have an order. HF is having lesser bond length than HCl, than HBr, than HI. Then, bond order or number of bonds. So, bond length, which is inversely proportional to number of bonds, or bond order. And bond energy, which is directly proportional to number of bonds. So that we can observe here. We have three different types of carbon-carbon bonding. Carbon-carbon single bond, double bond, and triple bond. As the number of bonds increases, bond energy increases while bond length decreases. Then, resonance. Due to resonance, bond length affected. We know that carbon-carbon single bond length is 1.54 Armstrong and carbon-carbon double bond length is 1.34 Armstrong unit. But if you consider in benzene, we know that delocalization of pi electron takes place. Hence, the bond in benzene, which is in between single as well as double bond, with the bond length 1.39 Armstrong unit. So, hybridization. Bond length inversely proportional to S character. As the S character in the compound increases, bond length decreases. We can observe the examples here in the table. The second bond parameter is bond angle. It's an angle between two adjacent bonds is known as bond angle, and it is represented in degrees, minutes, and seconds. Factors affecting bond angle. Number of bonds. Bond angle directly proportional to number of bonds, that is bond order. If the number of bonds between the atom increases, then bond angle also increases. Hybridization. We consider case one, that is when hybridization is same, bonded atoms are same, central atom and lone pair are different. Then bond angle, which is inversely proportional to number of lone pair. If you consider the sp3 hybridization for CH4, NH3 and H2O molecule, all are sp3 hybridization, all undergoes sp3 hybridization, the central atom, but the bond angle in CH4 molecule is 109, which is greater than 107, that is for NH3, and for H2O it is 105. Because of increasing number of lone pair electrons. Then case two, when hybridization C is same, bonded atoms are same, lone pair is same, but central atom is different. Then bond angle directly proportional to electronegativity of central atom. So if you consider an example of NH3, PH3, ASH3. So the bond angle is decreases like 107 degree, greater than 93 degree, greater than 91 degree. Because electronegativity across the period decreases, bond angle decreases. Then case three, when hybridization is same, lone pairs are same, central atom is same, then bonded atoms are different. OF2, Cl2O, Br2O. In all these molecules, oxygen is the central atom, but which is bonded to different atoms. And all these molecules in which central atom undergoes sp3 hybridization. And the bond angle for OF2, which is in between 103 to 105, in Cl2O, 109 to 111 degree, In Br2O, it is in between 116 to 118 degree. As we move from OF2, Cl2O and Br2O, electronegativity of bonded atom is decreasing. So here, bond angle is inversely proportional to electronegativity of bonded atom and directly proportional to size of side atom, that is adjacent atom. Then the third bond parameter is bond energy. Bond energy may be defined as bond formation energy or bond dissociation energy. Bond formation energy is energy released when any bond is formed, is known as bond formation energy or bond energy. Bond dissociation energy is energy required to dissociate any bond. Dissociate means energy required to break any bond is known as bond dissociation energy. Calculation of released energy is more difficult than the dissociation energy. Therefore, dissociation energy of bond is calculated and is assumed as bond energy or bond formation energy. So, case one, in diatomic molecule, bond energy is equal to bond dissociation energy. N2 greater than O2 greater than H2 greater than F2. As the bond order increases, bond energy also increases. So that we know that nitrogen consists of triple bond, oxygen, double bond, hydrogen, single bond, and fluorine is also having single bond. Case 2, for polyatomic molecule, bond energy, which is equal to bond dissociation energy. Example, CH4 molecule having bond energy equal to CH bond, that is 99.5 Kelvin calorie per mole. Then, theoretical values of bond dissociation energy of individual CH bonds in CH4 are given as follows. So, when the first bond is broken in CH4, the bond dissociation energy is 102 Kelvin calorie per mole. Similarly, for second bond, 105 kilocalorie per mole. So, for third bond, 108 kilocalorie per mole. And for fourth bond, 83 kilocalorie per mole. So, it's not a Kelvin, it's a kilocalorie per mole, because it's a bond dissociation enthalpy. So hence bond energy E for CH bond in methane, that is 398 divided by 4, which is equal to 99.5 kilocalorie per mole. Then bond dissociation energy is related to the state of hybridization. Factors affecting the bond energy, one is change in electronegativity, bond order, atomic size, bond polarity, resonance, hybridization, lone pair electrons. Electronegativity, bond energy directly proportional to the change in electronegativity. HF greater than HCl greater than HBr greater than HI. Bond order, which is directly proportional to bond energy. So carbon-carbon single bond, which is having lesser bond energy than carbon-carbon double bond than carbon-carbon triple bond. Atomic size, which is inversely proportional to bond energy. So exception in case of halogen group, order of bond energy is like chlorine-chlorine bond energy, which is greater than bromine-bromine, and in fluorine molecule and in iodine molecule. Because of higher electron density and small size of fluorine atom, repulsion between of two fluorine atom weakens the bond energy. Bond polarity, which is greater than, directly proportional to bond energy. HF greater than HCl greater than HBr greater than HI. Resonance, bond energy increases due to resonance. In benzene, bond energy of carbon-carbon increases due to pi electrons of carbon-carbon double bond. Hybridization, bond energy directly proportional to S character in hybrid orbitals. So sp-sp hybridization, which is greater than sp2-sp2 greater than sp3-sp3. In which S character in sp is 50, in sp2 is 33.3, in sp3 it is 25%. Lone pair of electron, bond energy inversely proportional to lone pair of electron. So carbon-carbon, there is no lone pair electrons are present, hence bond energy is greater than nitrogen, than oxygen, than fluorine. Then the second theory, that is VSEPR theory. Lewis' concept is unable to explain the shapes of molecule. This theory provides a simple procedure to predict the shapes of covalent molecules. Sidgwick and Powell in 1940 proposed a simple theory based on the repulsive interaction of the electron pairs in the valence shell of a central atom. It was further developed and redefined by Nyholm and Gillespie. The main postulates of VACPR theory are as follows. The shape of a molecule depends upon the number of valence shell electron pair around the central atom. Pairs of electron in the valence shell repel one another since the electron clouds are negatively charged. These pairs of electron tend to occupy such a position in space that minimize the repulsion interaction and thus maximize the distance between them. The valence shell is taken as a sphere with the electron pair localizing on the spherical surface at maximum distance from one another. A multiple bond is treated as it is a single electron pair, and the two or three electron pairs of multiple bond are treated as a single super pair. Where two or more resonance structures can represent a molecule, the VACPR model is applicable to any such structure. And the repulsive interaction of electron pairs decreases in the order. Lone pair interaction greater than lone pair, greater than bond pair interaction. Here, we have given shape of some simple molecule or ions with central atom or ion having no lone pair of electron. If the number of electron pair are 2, then arrangement of molecule is in linear shape with bond angle 180 degree. And the molecular geometry is BAB. That is AB2 type of molecule. Example, BeCl2, HgCl2. If the number of electron pairs are 3, then the triangular planar structure with the bond angle 120 degree, which is of AB3 type. Example, BF3. If number of electron pairs are 4, then which is exists a tetrahedral nature with the bond angle 109.5 degree. And the type of molecule is AB4. Example, CH4, NH4 plus. If the number of electron pairs are 5, then trigonal bipyramidal shape with two types of bond angle. One is 90 degree, another one is 120 degree. Then the type of molecule is AB5. Example, PCl5. Then if the number of electron pairs are 6, then they exhibit octahedral nature with the same bond angle, that is 90 degree. And the type of molecule is AB6, example SF6. Then, shape of some simple molecules or ions with central atom or ion having one or more lone pair of electrons. The molecule type is AB2E, where B represents the bonded pair, E represents the lone pair, so that we can predict the number of bonded pair as well as lone pair by observing the formula of the compound. So, shape of AB2E molecule is bent shape, example SO2 and O3. Then AB3E, shape will be trigonal pyramidal, example NH3. Then AB2E2, example H2O, which is having bent shape or inverted V shape. AB4E, seesaw shape, example is SF4. AB3E2, T-shaped structure with example ClF3. AB5E, square pyramidal, example BrF5. AB4E2, square planar, example XeF4. Then hybridization. It is defined as the concept of intermixing of orbitals of same energy or slightly different energy to produce entirely new orbitals of equivalent energy and identical shapes, and which are symmetrically disposed in plane. The number of hybrid orbitals on central atom of a molecule or ion, which is equal to number of sigma bonds plus lone pair of electron. The first bond between two atoms will be sigma. The other bond between same two atoms will be pi bond. Maximum two pi bonds may be present on a single atom. The electron pair of an atom which do not take part in bond formation called as lone pair of electron. One element can represent many hybridization state depending upon the experimental conditions. For example, We know that carbon exhibits sp, sp2, sp3 hybridization in its compounds. Hybrid orbitals are differentiated as sp, sp2, sp3, etc. The order of repulsion between lone pair, bond pair is lone pair, which is having greater repulsion than lone pair, bond pair, than bond pair interaction. The directional properties in hybrid orbitals is more than atomic orbitals. Therefore, hybrid orbitals form stronger sigma bond. The directional property of different hybrid orbitals will be following the order. sp lesser than sp2, lesser than sp3, lesser than sp3d, lesser than sp2d2, less than sp3d3. Then, what are the difference between hybridization and overlapping? Overlapping, it occurs between orbitals of two atoms. Hybridization, it occurs among the orbitals of same atom. Overlapping, only half-filled orbital takes part in overlapping, while any type of orbital can participate in hybridization. Overlapping occurs during bond formation, bond formed after hybridization. So hybridization process just before overlapping. Orbitals of different energies may participate in excited states in case of overlapping. So in hybridization, it takes place in ground or in excited state. So in ground state, NH3, NCl3, PH3, PCl3, etc. Molecular orbitals are formed by overlapping. So hybrid orbitals are formed by hybridization. So how can one determine the hybridization state? The first method, count the following pair of electrons around the central atom. One is count all pure sigma bond electron pair, that is sigma bonds. Count all the lone pair of electron, then count coordinate bond and count negative charge. Then in method 2, to predict hybridization, following formula may be used. Number of hybrid orbital, which is equal to half into total number of valence electron in the central atom plus total number of monovalent atom minus charge on the cation plus charge on the anion. If you consider NH4 plus half, total number of valence electron in nitrogen is 5 and total number of monovalent atom is 4 minus charge on cation is 1. Then there is no charge on anion, hence it is 0. So that 4, sp3 hybridization. SF4, which consists of 5, then sp3d hybridization. SO4 2 minus 4, that is sp3 hybridization. NO3 minus 3, sp2 hybridization. So if such type of electron pairs are, then if 2 electron pairs, then sp hybridization, 3 sp2 hybridization, 4 sp3, 5 sp3d, 6 sp3d2, 7 sp3d3. So sp linear shape, sp2 trigonal pyramidal, sp3 tetrahedral, sp3d trigonal bipyramidal, sp3d2 or d2sp3 octahedral, sp3d3 trigonal. So which is having pentagonal bipyramidal shape, sp3d3, which is having 1, 2, 3, 4 pentagonal bipyramidal. Okay, like this. So pentagonal bipyramidal. Table that shows shapes of molecules on the basis of VSEPR theory and hybridization. So just now I have discussed sp linear, sp2 trigonal planar, sp2 some molecules shows angular, that is bent shape, etc. sp3 or dsp2 tetrahedral, sp3 or dsp2 pyramidal, sp3 or sp2 bent shape, sp3d trigonal bipyramidal, sp3d seesaw shape, sp3d bent T shaped, sp3d linear shape, sp3d2 octahedral, square pyramidal, square planar, then sp3d3 pentagonal bipyramidal, then pentagonal pyramidal and pentagonal planar. Then dipole moment. So similar to Fajan's rule, here dipole moment explains the ionic nature in covalent bond. The polarity of any polar covalent bond or molecule is measured in terms of dipole moment, which is represented by symbol mu. For measurement of extent of polarity, Pauling introduced the concept of dipole moment. So it is a product of positive or negative charge, and the distance between two poles is called dipole moment. Here mu, which is equal to q into d, where q is magnitude of the charge and d is the distance. Dipole moment is a vector quantity, that is, it has both magnitude as well as direction. Direction of dipole moment is represented by an arrow pointing from electropositive and to electronegative element, and from central atom to lone pair of electron. Unit of dipole moment is d by, and 1 d by, which is equal to 1 into 10 power minus 18 and 1.6 into 10 power minus 29 in coulombs meter. Application of dipole moment: to determine the polarity and geometry of the molecule, to calculate percentage of ionic character by using the formula percentage of ionic character, which is equal to experimental value of mu divided by theoretical value of mu into 100, and to distinguish cis form to trans form. Some important orders of dipole moment, that is HF greater than H2O greater than NH3 greater than NH3 and H2O greater than H2S. CH3Cl greater than CH3F greater than CH3Br greater than CH3I. Then PF3 lesser than NF3 lesser than NH3. HF greater than H2O greater than SO2 greater than NH3. And PH3 less than PCl3. NO2 minus greater than NO2 greater than NO2 plus. H2O less than H2O2. Then the last theory is molecular orbital theory, that is MOT. There is linear combination of atomic orbitals are to form molecular orbitals. The number of molecular orbitals produced is equal to the number of atomic orbitals that are combined. Two types of molecular orbitals are formed. One is bonding molecular orbitals at a lower energy than the combining atomic orbitals, which have favor bond formation. And the second one is anti-bonding molecular orbitals at a higher energy than the combining atomic orbital, which opposes the bond formation. Electrons are filled in the increasing order of energy of the molecular orbitals, which is in order of Bohr rule. When total electrons in the molecule or ions are more than 14, simple order of energy level of molecular orbital. So sigma 1s less than sigma star 1s, less than sigma 2s, less than sigma star 2s, less than sigma 2px, less than pi 2py, less than pi star 2py, less than sigma star 2py, 2px, less than pi 2py, 2pz. So here it is equal to, because we know that pi 2py and pi 2pz, which are equal to each other. Similarly, pi star 2py and pi star 2pz equal to each other. So this gives the increasing energy or increasing order of orbitals. And when total number of electrons in the molecules or ions are less than or equal to 14, that is modified order of energy level of molecular orbital. Sigma 1s less than sigma star 1s, less than sigma 2s, less than sigma star 2s. Up to here, both are same. Then changes pi 2py, which is equal to pi 2pz, less than sigma 2px, less than pi star 2py equal to pi star 2pz, less than sigma star 2px. So, which gives increasing order for molecule having electrons less than or equal to 14. So, here, from molecular orbital theory, that is, while writing the electronic configuration, one can determine bond order by using the formula half into number of bonding electron minus number of antibonding electron. If bond order is zero for any molecule, then it will not exist. Then we can also predict the magnetic nature, whether it is paramagnetic or diamagnetic. If all the electrons in a species are paired, then the substance is said to be diamagnetic, which is repelled by magnetic field. If some of the electrons in a species are unpaired, then the substance is paramagnetic, which is attracted by magnetic field. Then nature of the bond. Integral bond order values of 1, 2, or 3 corresponds to single, double, or triple bonds respectively. Molecular orbital configuration of some molecules. For H2, it is sigma 1s2. Bond order is 1, hence it is diamagnetic. For H2 plus, it is sigma 1s1. Bond order is half. That is paramagnetic. H2 minus, and the electronic configuration is sigma 1s2, sigma star 1s1. Bond order is half again. Then paramagnetic. Helium, He2. Bond order is 0 because electronic configuration sigma 1s2, sigma star 1s2, which does not exist in nature. N2, sigma 1s2, sigma star 1s2, sigma 2s2, sigma star 2s2, pi 2px2, pi 2py2, sigma 2pz2. Bond order is 3, hence it is diamagnetic. N2 plus, with bond order 2.5, diamagnetic. N2 minus, bond order 2.5, paramagnetic. N2 2 minus, bond order is 2, paramagnetic. O2, bond order is 2, paramagnetic. O2 plus, bond order 2.5, paramagnetic. O2 minus, bond order 1.5, paramagnetic. O2 2 minus, bond order 1, diamagnetic. Ne2, which does not exist because of bond order 0. Cn, bond order is 2.5, paramagnetic. Cn minus, bond order is 3, diamagnetic. No, bond order is 2.5, paramagnetic. No plus, bond order is 3, diamagnetic. So these are some of the examples of molecular orbital theory. So here is one of the example, like how to write molecular energy level diagram. So I have taken the example of oxygen, which has the electronic configuration sigma 1s2, sigma star 1s2, sigma 2s2, sigma star 2s2, sigma 2pz2, pi 2px4, pi star 2p, that is pi 2px4 means pi 2px2 and pi 2py2, and pi star 2px1, pi star 2py1. So still it consists of even number of electron. In antibonding molecular orbital, it consists of unpaired electron. Hence, oxygen molecule is paramagnetic. And the bond order is 2. Hence, oxygen consists of double bond between two oxygen atoms. So this is a concept map of the chemical bonding and molecular structure. So, students, if this video is helpful for you, please like, then share with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe. So thanks for watching. So keep supporting and subscribe the channel and share it to the maximum. Thank you.